And I'm very happy to hear your talk here. So today I'll talk about cross-site splitting. So this is joint work with these five guys. And today I work over Azure cross field opposite characteristic. First, I would like to start by what is cross-site splitting. So this is a generalization of splitting. And also, cross-site splitting varieties satisfy many good properties as split varieties. Cross-site F-split varieties satisfy similar property. As a split variety. So now I want to give the definition of cross-site splitting. And before that, I would like to recall the definition of split variety. First, take a variety. As I said, we work over Azure cross field or positive characteristic. Then we consider the following small field. Which is homeomorphism, and it's ring map is given by people map. Then we say that X is split if this in this OX module homeomorphism. As I said, so this is considered as an OX linear homomorphism, OX module homomorphism. So this definition can be given by this diagram. I mean, we have injection, so splitting is this direction. And the conversion is first we take F and from F push to the OX is IE. This is the definition of splitting. And before giving the definition of cross-site splitting, I would like to give an answer way to see this diagram. We first have these properties. And we copy OX, which is the source of this map. Then this splitting can be considered as this arrow. Now I would like to give the definition of cross-site splitting. We say that X is cross-site splitting if the following diagram. We have the factorization following by diagram. We first have W and OX. I'll give the definition of W and OX later. And we have four units for Wn. We have projection from Wn to user OX. Then the definition is the factorization for some n. And the usual splitting can be considered as n equal one case on this diagram. I now give the definition of this F and Wn and R. This is a bit technical. So in what form do we fix positive integer n? The first notarial case is n is equal to 2, because if n is equal to 1, then Wn works is just the usual OX. Anyway, so this Wn OX is a ring sieve, sieve of ring on X. And Wn is a functor from the category of FP algebra to the category of Z over P and Z algebra. FP means Z over PZ. So we have, if we have a ring of Jackson P, then we can define Z over P and Z algebra. And this is a functor. So if we have a ring of positive characteristic, then WnA is a kind of lift. Then after giving definition, WnOx can be defined naturally, I mean for open subset of X. The sheaf is defined as Wn of this ring. The formal definition of bit vector WnA is quite complicated, but it is useful to know some properties. So this is maybe the situation is similar to tensor product. I think definition itself is okay, but construction is not so useful, but the universal property is very important for tensor product. So bit vector is very similar to some. Like that. So I would like to summarize some properties here. First, as I said, WnA is a direct product of A. So this is n copies of A. And usually, the first component is considered as the zeroth component, and the second one is the first component, and the third one is it's something like this, A0, L1, L2. Usually we use such index. This is just, as I said, this is not the quality of rings. And the second property, WnFP is equal to Z over P and Z. And as a third property, as I said, this Wn is a functor. So if we have a ring of homomorphism, then we get another ring homomorphism. Ring homomorphism of FP algebra. Of course, so this is automatically FP, so this can be considered as FP algebra homomorphism. And then by the fact that Wn is a functor, we get another ring of homomorphism. And the property I now want to show is that this map, this ring of homomorphism, is component-wise map, I mean, if so WnA is direct product of A, then component wise A0 goes to phi A0 and A1 goes to phi A1 and this N minus 1 goes to phi A. So as a consequence, we get the following properties. If phi is injective, then also Wn phi is also injective. Similar thing holds for the subjectivity. So if we are basically interested in the case where A is for finite type over K. So we start with FP, then we have a field, adjoint cross field, and we have a map injection from K to A if A is not the ring. As I said, the injectivity is stable undertaking Wn. So we have this injectivity. And as I mentioned, WNFP is to the PNZ, and actually WNA is the characteristic of WNA is P to the N. And it is known that if K is adjoint cross field, then its WNK is a local outing. So local outing ring. And also we can show that this extension, the latter field is closed. The rotor field, rotor ring extension is of finite type. In particular, WLA is Noetherian ring. So now I want to go back to what we want to define. So we want to define the crystal splitting. So in order to define crystal splitting, we need Hermite action for Wn and also projection written as R. Hermite is just a WN of Frobenius. I mean, we have Frobenius ring homomorphism in positive characteristic. Then we have WNF. This is component wise repeat keeper map. And this is also called as Frobenius. And by a bit of notation, this is written by F. And finally, we have other ring map, ring homomorphism, which is called as restriction or projection. This is ring home. This is defined by forgetting the last component. It is not so trivial, but this is known that this is known to be ring homomorphism. And then if we take this, we apply this R and n-1 times, then n becomes 1, so W1A, and also it is well known that W1A is equal to A. So now I would like to show the definition of the crystal splitting again. This was defined as we first take the Frobenius, and we also consider the projection and the definition is a factorization of this diagram. Now, more precisely, this is this diagram is considered as WN or X module homomorphism. So factorization is required to be WN or X linear. So now I would like to show you some properties or main question of this talk. We take smooth projective variety. Then the main question asks when X is greater than 3. Of course, this question is very vague, so we have many answers, but what I want to know is basically what kind of condition implies crystal splitting or crystal splitting implies some property. So we want to as many properties as like this. So for example, this follows from the definition, but of course, splitting implies crystal splitting. More concretely, for example, toric variety that splitting, and also ordinary Abelian variety split, so it is going to have split ordinary Abelian variety. But also rational homogeneous variety are known to be split. But this precise split variety is a generalization of split variety, so it is quite tempting to know that no example which is precise split but not split. So in order to find such example, we want to know some criteria. So I mean here, so if precise split, it satisfies Kodaira branching. And also, it satisfies if X is quasi split, then its Kodaira dimension is at most zero. And also, X lifts to W2. As a typical case, so Kodaira dimension is at least zero. So typical case, as K trivial case, and also the final case. I would like to focus on these two cases. And before that, first I would like to mention case of dimension one. So we take a smooth projective curve. Then X is greater than split if and only if the genus is at most one. I mean, the genus is zero or one. Okay, so I think I should go to the next page. Sorry, let me write it again. So we take a smooth projective curve. Then X is greater than split if and only if the genus is zero or one. So as I mentioned, if x is greater than spirit, x is greater than spirit, then its collider major is at most zero. So it implies this implication. As for the opposite implication, if the collider major is zero, then it is P1, then projective space are split, so it is greater than split. So the remaining case is genus one case, so empty curve case. In this case, if it is super singular, it is greater than split. And more generally, we have answer for RBM variety. If X is an Abelian variety, then X is greater than split. If and only if it's P rank, it's largest or second largest. I mean, this is largest case is dimension X. The next case is dimension X minus one. And also it is good to mention that this largest case is nothing but a splitting case. And also this P rank is defined as number of pretension points. Then this can be written as P to something, but and this something is nothing but a P rank. And okay, so then this might be very well known, but the P rank is known to be from zero to dimension X. So this might be enough, but maybe if I want to show you more concrete examples. So if we fix two elliptic curves, one of them is ordinary and the other is supersingular. So ordinary means the ordinary is P rank is equal to one and the super singular is P rank zero case. Then we take the direct product of many of ordinary empty curve and many of super singular empty curve. Okay, R can be zero and S can be zero. Then in this case, we can easily check that the P rank is equal to R. So the theorem here said that X is quasi split if and only S is equal to zero or one. So as a first non-quasi splitting case, if we take the direct product of super singular elliptic curve, then it is not quasi split. So this might be interesting because these direct factors themselves are quasi split, but if we take direct product of them, then it will be not quasi split. So being quasi split is not safe under taking direct product. Okay, I only give a sketch of the proof. Only idea. So P rank is basically related to Bristol cohomology. It gives some information for slopes of Bristol cohomology. And the quasi splitting is basically similar related to the highest part of WMOX. But we want to compare these two cohomologies. But for abelian varieties, we can even just taking wet product, we get the crystalline cohomology of dimension X. Then it is well known fact that some part of the upper cohomology is the lower one. Okay, I do not go to the details anymore, but the proof is something like this. Now, if I mention the one-dimensional case and the abelian varieties, so I also want to mention the case of strict Caribbean case. This is just by Yoko. We take a smooth Caribbean variety in the strongest case sense. I mean, case trivial and intermediate cohomology vanishing. Then there is a characterization of crystal splitting by adding the height. This is an invariant of this Caribbean variety, and its value is positive integer or infinity. And the split case is, in this case, X is a split if and only if the height is equal to one. And for the case of K3, this height is bounded up to 10 as far as it is finite. In a sense, so there are good answers for Caribbean case. So now I want to talk about the final case. The case where minus case is ample. As I mentioned, if a given variety is quasi split, then it satisfies the quasi vanishing. And it is known that there exists a smooth fan variety. For given any characteristic, which is a counter example to quasi vanishing. Then this X is not quasi split. And I only want to mention what is the dimension of this counter example. If p is equal to 2, such dimension, such counter example is given in dimension 6. This is given by Rowitz and Lau. And the remaining case, the auto characteristic case, the dimension 2p plus 1, given by Totaro. At least in large characteristic case, so it exists in this funnel, which is not crystal space. So the next question is, how about the lower dimensional case? So as I said, for the case of curve, there is nothing to do. So P1 is a precise speed. Yeah, it is only funnel. So just first non-trivial case is that in dimension two. So in dimension two, so if X is two dimensional funnel, so variety, so it is smooth degree surface. Then it is always crystal speed. Now I would like to add two remarks. First, a split version does not hold in general, but if P is at least seven, then a split version holds. I mean, if X is smooth debris surface and the characteristic is at least seven, then it is a split. And the counter example is known to any low characteristic. And for example, if P is equal to two, then Fermat cubic is not a split. But this is a crystal split, of course. Another remark is in the three-dimensional case, it is tempting to hope that smooth funnels three for the crystal split or not. But it exists counter example in chapter three. It is again Fermat type. This is smooth funnel three for, which is not crystal split. So in this one and two, so I claim that some variety is crystal split or not crystal split. So now I'd like to explain how to check given variety is crystal split. At least, so I mean, what is the idea in to prove this result? The first one is, for the first one, we establish our result inversion adjunction type result. As for the second one, so, this is not my result, but there is a further criterion for splitting and Kawakami and Takamatsu and Yoshikawa establish a further type criterion for crystal splitting. So basically, given explicit equation, then we can check whether it is crystal split or not for many cases. So now I just explain what is this inversion merge action. The inversion adjunction is result to get good property of ambient space from the sub-variety. For example, if we have a variety and we have a Karate divisor, assume that this Karate divisor is regular or smooth, then its ambient variety is smooth along that Karate divisor. Inversion adjunction is a kind of such a result. So I'll try to explain very simple case. So we take smooth projective variety, we take a smooth prime divisor on X, and we import two conditions. This local divisor is trivial. In a sense, this is local trivial. And I also require one vanishing condition on cohomology. Then we conclude the inversion adjunction type result for Kreisler splitting. I mean, if S is Kreisler split, then also X is Kreisler split. And I want to explain why this inversion merge action theorem implies the two-dimensional funnel case. Smooth derivatives are Kreisler split. So what we want to show is we first take smooth derivative surface, and we want to show that this is Kreisler split. We first pick a general member of minus kx. It is known that this is smooth. This is not so trivial, but recently this is proved by Kawakami and Nagaoka. So this is every curve by junction. The other set, any smooth elliptic curve are Kreisler split. So by using inversion adjunction, we get that X is Kreisler split. Now I would like to explain the proof of this inversion merge action. So first, it is good to start with the usual split case. So for the split, there is an inversion merge action for splitting. And a similar statement. So in order to prove that, we first consider the following diagram. We have OX and restriction map to OS. And of course, it kind of is IS, it's the ideal shift. Then we take consider the commutative diagram induced by frog mu's. Like this. the upper sequence is obtained by F push by taking F push to the lower sequence. Then the strategy is just take dual and we compute some cohomology. And why we take, the reason why we take this dual is as follows. What we want to know is the splitting of this map. The splitting is the same as the subjectivity of the dual. This is obtained from me. So, I mean, for example, if this is surjective, then identity map is lives here, then it means the splitting. Okay, so this is a splitting case. The quasi splitting case is basically, in a sense, very, very similar. So I only point out what is how to modify the proof. So quasi splitting coming from, so quasi splitting is defined as a factorization of this diagram. But by taking a push out of this diagram, the factorization of this diagram is equivalent to the splitting of this map. This is that this can be checked by using the fact that this is a push-out diagram. Then what we will do is just replace frog news by this OX to Q. So of course we need to check many details, but basically by using such observations, then we can show that this is a bunch of large function. Okay, so now I would like to consider a similar question to the main question. Similar means local version of the main question. I mean, so if we take normal affine variety, then it is tempting to ask when X is quasi split. So this local version is usually called as pure for the splitting case. So we also consider this local case is called as quasi pure. More precisely, it is defined as follows. We say that X is quasi pure if we can find an open cover such that each piece is quasi split. And the existence of covering is equivalent to any covering. I mean, if we take any affine open, of X, then it is quasi split. Here now, I want to consider the local voice version of Fano case. So I mean, in Bayesian geometry, Fano is basically corresponding to KLT singularity. For example, if we have Fano and we take cone of that, then it will give KLT singularity. And we can take that if we have precise splitting variety and we take a cone, then we get precise FPL singularity. So I would like to talk about the relation of these singularities. And as I said, for smooth form, there exists for any characteristic, there exists smooth form variety, which is not precise splitting. Then if we take cone that, then it is KLT, but not precise FPL. For any characteristic, there exists KLT singularity, which is not precise split. So as in the local case, as in the global case, it is attempting to ask the local case in lower dimension. In this direction, we have the following results. Two-dimensional KLT singularities are always precise pure. A three-dimensional case, we also have some results, but I need to add q-factorial condition. This is not so strong, but we need to assume this. And also, the precise split, but we need to assume that the characteristic is very large. Now I'm going to add some remarks on this theorem. First, a splitting FPL case, theorem A is known characteristic at least 7. This is a result by Hara. Two-dimensional KLT singularities are FPL if the characteristic is at least 7. As for part B, there is no analog for usual FPL case. I mean, B fails if we replace quasar FPL by FPL. This is a result by a joint work with Cassini and Petashek. And also, as I said, this is, we need to import the assumption that the characteristic is very large in part B. At least we have already found a counter example in low characteristic, and the highest characteristic is 41. I mean, there is this three-dimensional q-factorial KLT singularity, which is not quasar split. That example found in characteristic 41. Now, I would like to give the idea for theorem B. So, three dimensional case. So, we use again a kind of inversion of adjunction, which is different from the former one. So I inversion of adjunction too. And also, we need a log version of quasi splitting. And assuming these tools, I would like to give a sketch of the proof. So what we want to show is as follows. We first have a three-dimensional galaxy singularity. Then we take a Brasher morphism from Y, which extracts the prime divisor. Such that with some good properties. So I don't want to explain the detail, but this is very similar to for example, if X is cone and then it is a contraction of negative section of P1 bundle, then S is a negative section and the Y is that P1 bundle. So this X and Y are similar to that situation. Then we consider the adjunction. Then for smooth case, KY plus, if we take the restriction of KY plus S to S, then it will be KS. But for the singular case, we have some effective divisor, which is Q with Q rational coefficients. Then what we will prove, we can prove is this pair is quasi split. Then by using a result of a kind of inversion adjunction, then we can show that this Y is quasi split. The original prime variety X is quasi split. This second implication is easy. The key part is the first implication and also the quasi splitting of this pair. Okay, so I do not give the definition theorem on this one, but I would like to mention the log version definition for the log version, we say that the given pair is quasi split. If we have the factorization of the from diagram. So if delta equals zero, then it is the case I have explained, but if we add this delta, then these two parts have some twist. And here, WN or delta is something similar to WN or X, but we allow some pole condition. I mean, this is again, as I said, a direct product, but each function is required to have some, each function can be allowed to have some pole coming from this delta. And this OXPI delta is nothing but round down of PI the time delta. I just want to mention some variants of quasi splitting. So we also have iterated version. I mean, usually in theory of splitting, it is very useful to consider the iterative version. But for the quasi splitting case, if we consider similar naive analog, then that definition does not work. But we can, in our joint work, we have some good definition. Iterated case. And also we have defined the quasi regularity, which is analog of wave regularity. Okay, now I have 3 minutes, so I want to mention what is why the naive analog is mean. Is not good. So usually, so the quasi splitting is defined as the factorization of this diagram. Then it is quite tempting to define the iterative version like this. But then, if it is at least two, X is usually splitting. So it is too strong. So this does not give anything. So we need to modify the definition, but it is what I wanted to say. So now I think I would time to stop here. So thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, any questions or comments? I just want to have a stupid question. So you in the definition of quasi F split, you have this N, I mean, some level of the bit ring. So in which N or how is it related to X?
So if n is smaller, then it's better. So for example, super singularity curve, n can be taken to be two. But if the variety becomes worse, then n becomes larger. But as far as we can take such n, then it satisfies good property. But if n is smaller, then the variety can be considered better.
Okay, so n is but it's fixed for any okay, it's I see. So it's a kind of you make some choice of n for x, but you don't fix it a priori.
I don't know if this answers your question, but if we get the factorization for Wn, then we get the factorization for Wn plus one because we have this diagram. So if splitting is given by 10, then splitting is given for 11 or something
yeah.
like that. So
how about letting n to infinity? Do you have something for the bit ring? I mean the bit ring, not the truncated, but the bit ring of x.
And then not n, but it's infinity. You're asking that you don't that be you.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think at least in our joint work, we did not consider such case. Yeah, of course, it might have some.
The splitting, they don't glue together, yeah? They don't glue together, yeah. Let's see.
If we have factorization for n, then of course we have factorization for infinite case. But I think even if we have factorization for infinite, even if we have this one, I do not know whether this implies a factorization for this one for large n. So there might be a difference between them.
Yeah. But if you have only some and on some level, you cannot leave them to the bitring. Yeah.
You're asking about lifting.
Yeah.
Lifting. So I think we only know lifting to. So as I said, if we have it is quasar split, then it lifts to W2, but lifting to WK is quite, I think it's quite hard to conclude it. It's not so related, I think. This is just a case.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, so if there are no other questions and comments, so let us thank the speaker, Professor Hiromu Tanaka from University of Tokyo.